We're moving.
March 11th, 2011. The island nation of Japan suffers a devastating earthquake and tsunami. 6 months later, members of the Misawa community in northern Japan still have clear memories of that day, even if they weren't here yet.
It had been about 8 to 10 hours since the earthquake had actually happened here in Japan, and I was just looking at some YouTube videos, specifically of Sendai. And my wife turned to me after checking her email and said, "We have an assignment." And I said, "Really?" She said, "Yes." I said, "Where are we going?" She says, "Misawa, Japan." And I had one of those moments with the scratching record kind of thing where I looked at her and said, "Are you serious?" And she says, "Of course I'm serious. Why wouldn't I be serious?" And I said, "Have you seen the news at all today?" And she says, "No, I haven't."
Earthquakes are common in Japan, but even longtime Misawa residents quickly realized that this one was different.
We think, you know, it's just another earthquake, so I just kind of wrote it out at my desk until things started falling off the shelves around me. Immediately, I was able to get a text to my husband, just said one word, "Whoa!" exclamation point.
With no power and limited phone lines available, information was hard to come by.
So we saw most of it on Facebook and the internet, and it was really horrifying, knowing that that was so close to us.
Family members struggled to contact one another. Parents of Misawa's varsity athletic teams had even more to worry about. Their kids were aboard a train just north of Tokyo when the earthquake hit.
The train started bouncing and it jerked real hard, like we had maybe hit something.
We look outside and the houses are shaking. There's buckets of water and the water is tipping over. And the cars were jumping up and down. The ones that were parked were jumping up and down.
And when we climbed out, I had realized that the train was derailed.
Some of these student athletes would not be able to speak to their parents for over 24 hours.
Oh, she was so relieved to hear us. Like you could hear her trying not to cry to be strong for us and stuff while we were just sobbing on the phone to her. And
6 months later, the scars remain, but people here are moving on. You can see this just by visiting one of the many areas devastated by the tsunami where Americans from Misawa Air Base came out by the busload to lend a helping hand. This is the city of Hachinohe, just days after the disaster. Here it is today. Walking along these docks now, it's hard to imagine the losses suffered by this community. It's even inspiring to see people thrive in the face of a disaster like this.
You know, people can come back from something no matter how devastating and just press on, just like we did from 9/11. You know, the United States came to almost complete stop for a couple of days. And it just is almost as if we had no direction and didn't know what to do. And then when the resolve finally set in to do something about it and come back from it, we moved on. And Japan has done the same thing. So those are kind of in parallel with each other. We moved on from 9/11, they've moved on from the tsunami and the earthquake, and they'll overcome it because they can, because that's what human beings do.
Airman First Class Jimmy Moreland, Misawa Air Base, Japan.